Diamonds on my neck. I like more than jets. I like more than sex.
Hey guys, it's Lexxi back with another video. Today I'm gonna be doing a story time. I don't do story time as much, but this is a good story, and I asked a few of my friends like what story time, and this is the one they chose. Before I start this video, make sure you give this video a thumbs up even though like it hasn't started, and subscribe to my channel down below. Follow me on all my social medias, and yeah. Today's video is about the story of the time. Oh, that's why they call it story time. The story of the time I ran away. I know that almost everyone has had like a feeling, not a feeling, but like an urge or like a thought to run away. Like everybody's wants to run away once in their lifetime. So I'm gonna tell you about the time I ran away. So it's already been a year. So this was, I don't know what day, like a Saturday or whatever. It doesn't matter because who cares? I was in my room. I was going through stuff at the time. I live with my grandparents and my like dad, but I was chilling in my room, and then all of a sudden like my grandparents come in and start like screaming at me. And if you guys know, my grandparents are like scary and like rude, but they can be cool sometimes. So my grandparents came in and they were like screaming at me because I think my hamster bit her massage thing, and she starts screaming at me and she like threw it on my bed. I have the videos of what happened, but I don't want to put them in because I don't know, I feel like they'll get mad if they watch it, or even if they don't, I don't know. I pushed the thing off my bed because like she just left it on my bed, and she comes in and like shit happens, and they start like getting stuff from my room and like throwing it everywhere, like breaking my stuff and everything. And I was so mad, and I called my dad because he was at work, and he was like, and I was telling him, and he just like, he didn't do anything about it, he didn't care. So they were like, clean your room. So I cleaned my room, and I was like, I'm so mad, like I can't be here anymore. And then they just kept talking shit, which made me think like, what if I wasn't here anymore? Like, what would they do? So that's technically the reason like I ran away, because I wanted to like give them a teach them a lesson. I know you shouldn't, if you guys are like thinking of running away, don't do it. Trust me, it's not worth it. So I was like, I'm gonna teach them a lesson. I did. I got a backpack. What was in the backpack? I think like sweater, clothes, and a toothbrush, and like my charger and stuff. That's all I had in the backpack. So they were in the living room, and I literally just like walked out the front door as if I was like taking trash out or something. So I just walked out the front door, and I was like, what am I gonna do? Like, I don't have a car at the time. I will never take the bus alone. I don't wanna walk anywhere. Like, what am I gonna do? So I start walking like down this way, down the block, and I remembered that I had my ex-boyfriend text me, like, we've been on and off for like two and a half years, we were on and off, we're off now, don't worry about that. So he texted me like a week earlier, was like, hey, what are you doing, let's hang out. And I was like, why the hell is he texting me? Like, no, I'm not hanging out with my ex-boyfriend. But then I was like, maybe I should pretend like I didn't see it and then ask him for a ride. So I texted him, I'm like, oh, I'm doing nothing, like, what's up? And then he was like, just checking on you. I was like, oh, do you wanna hang out? He was like, oh my God, yeah, let's do something. I was like, yeah, okay. So he was like, I'll be there in 5 minutes. Like, what the hell, like, clutch. Like, so he literally got here in 5 minutes. And so I was walking, and I went to the next block, and then the next block, and I was scared my dad was gonna come home. So I was like, I was on this lady's porch playing with her cat. And then she comes out and she like gets the cat and's like, come on. And I was like, oh, what? I was just playing with your cat. So she didn't let me play with her cat. So he pulls up, I get in the car, we're talking, we're still chill, but like, we're not chill, but like, it's not awkward between us, cause like we were dating for like 2.5 years and we're like best friends at the time. So I get in his car and he were like, where do you want to go? I was like, I don't know, anywhere. Like at this point, like still nobody noticed that I was gone. So I was like, he was like, oh, do you want to go to the beach? I'm like, I'm down. So we go to the beach. It's about 6-7 o'clock that we get to the beach. And like, we're just having a good time. Like no one's texting me. I'm not worried about anything. And I'm telling him the story of like, I just like walked out. And then, yeah. So we're hanging out at the beach. We are there for an hour, hour and a half, No, we're there for like 2 hours. He gets a parking ticket because he doesn't know how to park. We're going back home and he's like, do I take you home? I was like, no, I'm not going home. Like, no. And I was like, fuck, where do I go? Called my best friend at the time. And I was like, hey, this is going on. And she's always been there for me. No matter what I needed, she was there for me. So I was like, hey, I ran away. Can I come to your house? And she's like, yeah, the door is open. It's like 9 o'clock. We have a school the next day. She's like, yeah, the door is open. Come over, sleep over. I was like, bet. So I was going to her house. On the way there, this is when it all starts going bad. Like, on the way on the freeway, I think it started with my dad like usually just saying like, hey, where are you? Didn't reply. And then I kept getting, hey, where are you, where are you, where are you, like calls and calls. I just kept watching them ring. Like, this is how like selfish and dumb I am. I just kept like watching them ring, like watching my dad freak out that I'm not home. So then my brother texts me, my mom calls me. Like, my brother, my mom, and my dad are all the ones, like, calling me. This has been going on for, like, an hour and a half already. So, they're getting worried, obviously. Then I get my aunt texting me. All, like, my grandma, my dad, literally everyone calling me and texting me. Like, I'm so rude for just watching them. Like, how up is that? Like, they think that I could have got raped, I could have died, I could have done all this. But no, I'm just sitting here watching you guys call me. I just felt really, like, alone, and I felt like they didn't care about me and they didn't need me, stuff like that. So I wanted to run away. I knew for sure I was gonna come back, but like, what if like something happened to me, like for real? So they kept calling me. This was going on for about 3 hours now. My brother texted me and was like, if you need money, just please let me know. Just let me know you're safe, you can come live with me, like all that. But like, I didn't care. I just wanted them to keep worrying about me. So then my little cousins start crying, and my cousins were freaking out, and they started posting on their Instagram saying like, find Lexxi, has anyone seen Lexxi? My cousin even texted the boy I was with like, hey, where's Lexxi, are you with her? And he was like, no, like he lied for me. So then he starts texting my best friend. They text my best friend, they texted everyone except for the best friend I was going to, her house. Like, they didn't even think about her house. Like, what? I had a voicemail from my dad, like, on accident, like, them searching under my bed, them, like, searching my whole room. I came home and my whole room was, like, a mess. Like, everyone was trying to find me. And I was just chilling at the beach. So I get to my best friend's house, and we're just chilling there, and I'm talking to her. We're just having, like, a deep conversation, so, like, my phone's just over there ringing. I should have turned it off. Everyone was looking at my location, but somehow my location was not working. I don't know how. My mom called her best friend, who was a cop, and was like, hey, like, my daughter ran away, what do I do? It's only been like 5 hours, 6 hours. He was like, we can't do anything right now, but in 24 hours, if she's not back, let me know. We'll have a search out for her. But she'll probably like come back, like teens do this. And I really felt bad for my mom, because she didn't do anything. And I don't know, if I could go back in time, I would change it so much. So then I go to my best friend's house, we're talking, we're having a great time. I'm like, I'm gonna sleep over. And then she was like, okay, whatever. But we had school in the morning. I didn't want to go to school, because then they would call the office, see if I'm there and stuff like that. And I just didn't want to go home at the time. And then a few hours later, I'm like, what is this? Like, where do I think this is gonna go? Like, what's the point in this? Like, what am I doing? So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna just call my cousins and tell them that I'm at your house and I just don't wanna go home tonight. Because they were literally like on Facebook, everything. Like, everyone, I had DMs from like family far away and like old friends saying like, hey, are you okay? Like, where are you? Like, it was like crazy. So I was like, yeah, I'm just gonna call her. I'm gonna go home, or I'll tell her that I'm gonna like stay here for the night and go to school tomorrow and come home. So I texted my cousin saying, hey, I'm okay, I'm at blah blah blah's house. And then they all start calling me. They're like, answer your phone now, answer your phone. So I answer it, and they're like, Lexxi, like, where are you? Like, your cousins were crying. Like, what are you doing? Come home. Blah, blah, blah. I'm like, guys, like, I'm fine. Like, I just don't want to be at home right now. I want to be by myself. So they're like, no, like, we're coming to pick you up. Where are you? I'm like, whatever. I'm at blah, blah, blah's house. And I was thinking, because my aunt said I could stay at her house for a little bit. I was thinking I was going to go to her house. But my brother came, with his girlfriend Paula, and they like, it was so awkward walking to the car. I get in the car, I don't say one word. My brother and Paula picked me up. My brother is like talking shit to me, saying all this stuff, like how stupid I am and how dumb I am. And I was like, cool, this is another reason why I don't want to be home. So like, they're just there, it's awkward silence all the way home. I'm just thinking like, cause my dad was texting me like, making it worse. He's like, when you get home, I'm beat. You're so done. So I was like, fuck, I don't want to go home. I can't go home. But we pull up to the house. I'm sitting there, I'm like, this is my last day. I'm telling my friends, take care of my streaks, do all this. This is my last day on earth. I'm gonna get my butt beat. So I walk in the house, straight to my room. I go straight to my room. And I just like sit there, I'm like, shit. I'm waiting for my dad to come in. I know he's gonna come in. My dad comes in. He's like yelling at me, he's like, what the is your problem? Asking all these questions. Grounded me, went to my mom's house, which was like 2 hours away for the week, even though I was grounded and I was having like a vacation, technically a vacation. It was a really great time, even though I was grounded. The funny part is that we were shopping. I was literally shopping. I was grounded, but I was going on a shopping spree, so that's fun. And I had a big hickey on my neck. And I remember I told my mom that I was at my best friend's house the whole time. Like, I didn't tell her about the beach. I didn't tell her about going with my ex-boyfriend. But I had the biggest hickey on my neck. Like, it was so dark and big. And then, the wind blew it. And she was like, what is that? I was like, I'm done again. Like, I'm never getting my phone back. I was like, what do you mean? She's like, what's that on your neck? I was like, oh, it's from paintballing, because we went paintballing like the weekend before, and I was like, it's from paintball. My brother's like, that's not paintball. I know what paintball looks like. I was like, no, it's paintball. Trust me. And then he was like, no, it's not. I'm like, oh, it's when you grabbed me like by my neck, Devin. Devin's my brother. And he was like, no, it's not. I'm caught. So I just kept ignoring it. They're like, I'm telling dad. I was like, no, you're not. Like, don't tell dad and blah, blah, blah. And then I got my phone taken away for another week. So I didn't have my phone for like 3 weeks. So then came home, everything was chill. My dad and I didn't talk for like a week or two. Like, it was awkward silence, even though we lived in the same house. If you guys are thinking about running away, please don't do it. If you really need someone to talk to, you guys can always talk to me. If you enjoyed that story time and you want more story times, comment down below what type of story times or what a story about something. Give this video a thumbs up, share it to your friends, and follow me on all my social medias, which is on the screen and in the description. Subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys next video. Peace.